Hey, and welcome back to Tell Samira. Today I'm going to talk about how the narcissist loves to control your reality. Now, I tried to think, is this the same as gaslighting? But I really don't think this is the same as gaslighting. And I'm going to say the reason why. Let me know what you think in the comment section. If you haven't already subscribed, go ahead and subscribe. At the end, if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And please let me know what you think. So anyway, the reason they try to control your reality, I remember growing up with my mother as a child, even as a teen and as an adult. It's like whatever I said, she would always, not always, she would a lot of times tell me that that's wrong. For instance, if I said, oh, you know, I like green beans, but then a month later, I decided I didn't like green beans, I like broccoli. Well, that wasn't okay. I think a normal parent would be like, understand that the kids' taste buds change over time and that their preferences are going to change. And that's just part of growing up. It's okay. But not if you have a parent that's a narcissist. The narcissist can't understand that change. I don't know if this is part of the crazy making that they purposely do, or if this is just they can't handle change. But so for instance, I'd be like, yeah, I like this vegetable. Now it's like, what do you mean you like this vegetable, Samira? You didn't like that vegetable before. You said you like that. So that's what you like. You don't like this. And I'm like, well, I used to like it, but I don't like it now. No, you said you like that. So this is what you like. And I'm like, oh my God, what do you mean? And even as a kid, I was like, oh my God, you know, something's wrong. But as a kid, we internalize the problems that's going on with our parents, meaning that we think that we've done something, because in our minds, our parents are the greatest thing since sliced bread. And so, of course, our Superman, our Wonder Woman, they can't be crazy, can they? No. So as a kid, we're like, something has to be wrong with me, because why would this person who is supposed to love me treat me in this crazy way? So I always thought, man, that something was wrong with me. And I was like, oh, maybe I should have still liked Brussels sprouts. So I'm sure it wasn't Brussels sprouts, but you hang on with me. I know you get it. Whatever it was, I'm like, well, maybe I should still like that. You know, something wrong with this. Maybe something's wrong with me. I should like that, right? So this is all this crazy making behavior. Or for instance, not only do they just want to tell you your preferences are, they can't even handle, like, if you change your favorite color. So if one moment your favorite color was blue and you're like, yeah, I like blue, I want everything in blue, give me blue shoes, put blue barrettes in my hair, give me blue beads. I used to wear braids all the time. I was so cute. Yeah. Give me blue beads. And then if one day if I change to like, oh, my color is like pink. And my mother would be like, no, that can't be your favorite color. Your sister said pink is her favorite color, so you can't have pink. You gotta go back. Didn't you say your color was blue? Why are you trying to steal your sister's color? That's her color. And if I tell you this sounds so preposterous and so made up, I am not kidding you. This is the stuff that I would deal with. So it was like, okay, so I guess I can't have that color as my favorite color. Or if I do, I have to keep it to myself, because it's not acceptable in this household to have that favorite color. It's like, you can't change anything. If you said it one time, you have to stick by that. No room for fluctuations ever. Oh, anywho. Not only that, it's like the things that you feel isn't real. So, for instance, I have this medical condition that I don't want to go into. And, you know, I had proof that I had this medical condition because several doctors had diagnosed me with it and they couldn't figure out how to treat me. So, I have it on paper since I was like age 17 of what the diagnosis is. My mother knows because I was on her insurance. She would take me to the doctors and they would tell her what was going on. She knows because she would have to fill my prescriptions and probably pay the co-pays, so she knows. But one day I was talking about the actual problem, and she says, well, you know, I just think that's all in your head, that you really don't have that. That's just something in your head that you have to deal with. And I'm like, what? You know, and if you allow yourself, this is why I said, to me, it's sort of maybe like gaslighting, because with gaslighting, it's a manipulative tactic where they want to get you to doubt your reality. It's like they want to make you think that you're crazy, something's wrong with you, thinking that, oh, that didn't happen, because they're telling you it didn't happen when you know it was. And sometimes if you fall for this gaslighting or whatever this crazy making behavior is, it will really have you questioning, did this really happen? You know, maybe something's wrong with me. Did she say that? Did I do that? Oh my God, are other people thinking this way about me? Do I need psychotropic medication? Am I losing my mind? You know, but that's the thing about this thing. It's like, oh my God, like how can you have been there with me for all these years? I've had surgeries and you know what was going on, but you're telling me this is in my head. So not only with that, one time when I say I was crazy because I used to pay about $400 to fly from California to go home to Indiana to see them. Why would I do this when they treated me like crap? So this is where I say I played a part in this because it's like, and now I know better. It's like, I'm not going to pay anywhere to go where I am not wanted and you treat me like crap every time I come there. $400 for you to treat me like crap? No, thank you. You know, so, but anyway, this is when my days when I was still going around her. So I would go home and one time I was like, I didn't want to get up early because I was sleeping and she was already up. And I was like, yeah, I'm jet lag or something like that. And she's like, there's no such thing as jet lag. I think she said it was all metaphysical. She's like, that's all metaphysical, Samira. It's in your head. You just need to get over it. It's not a thing. I'm like, oh my God, because, you know, I'm like really tired. Matter of fact, I think this is not even when I flew from California to Indiana. This is when I studied abroad for a year in Finland. So imagine the time difference. I went from Finland and came home to Indiana, and she was telling, and it was like, I can't remember, 7 or 8 hour time difference. And my first day back, she's trying to tell me that I didn't have jet lag. So it's like, forget what you feel. It's not, for the narcissist, it's not real. They don't care. They can, because they lack that empathy, they can only understand it if it happens to them. You know, like for instance, she would always get this leg cramps or foot cramps and things. And she'd be screaming in the middle of the night and crying like a baby, a 400 almost pound woman, 6 foot with man hands and man feet, screaming and crying out, you know, for help. You know, she would talk crazy to me all day and be all kind of wicked, but then she wants people to come running. Me being the nice, compassionate one, my two sisters, I know they heard her and they're screaming and crying. They didn't care. They would stay in their beds like they didn't hear, and I should have took a lesson from them, but not me. I would go in there, Mom, what's the matter? You need something? Can I help you? You know, she'd be like, oh, yes, Sam, please massage this. Please massage my legs. And I would massage, but I'm going to tell you what I used to do. I ain't going to act like I'm a real nice all the time. Because I'm not, because you know why? One of the reasons I would go in there is because I would punish her so bad because it was no talking back. You couldn't have your own feelings. You can't have your own thoughts. You couldn't have question her, nothing. You couldn't be sad. You could only be happy because according to her, she was the best mom ever and gave us everything. And you and everyone wanted to be in our shoes. Like you couldn't be mad either. She'd be like, other people would die to have the life you have. And I'm like, really? Somebody signing up for this? Oh my God. You know, but anyway, I would go into her room and I would apply this deep pressure with my fingers and stuff in my elbows and her leg. And she'd be like, I think you're trying to punish me. I'm like, no, you got to put pressure on it to get that Charlie horse out. The key to the stop the cramping is to put pressure. And I would squeeze as hard as I could. I don't even think I ever heard that about the key to pressure. But oh, baby, I would give it back to her. I was so passive aggressive. Yes, I was. So anyway, that was like my little payback. But yeah, but for her, it was all, oh, she could feel that pain, but let it have been me. Oh, I know she would tell me, oh, it's in your head, Samira. You don't feel that. Suck it up, baby. Get over it. Get over yourself. Grow up. You don't feel that. For instance, as a child, I was playing with friends and hit my big toe on somebody's wooden table. The toe immediately started bleeding and my toe hurt and it would only feel better if I would pop it. So I would always have my sisters, I would get them a quarter or up to a dollar to pop my foot, my toe, and then because it kept bleeding and this happened like over a year. And my mother kept saying, and it didn't heal and feel right. My mother kept saying, I just wanted her attention. I was so jealous of my other two sisters. I just wanted her all for myself. This is what she was telling me. So eventually, because I kept crying and whining for it after a year, she finally took me to the hospital and they x-rayed it. And she told them before they gave the results, yeah, she just wants my attention. And the woman looked at my mother and said, ma'am, her toe is fractured. So imagine this, my toe had been fractured for over a year before she took me to the doctor because she was so obsessed with herself and could not believe that what I was saying was true. It had to be all about her and my reality was nothing. You know, something was wrong with me. I just needed some attention, as she would say. And the crazy thing about them is they say, oh, you just need attention. So if it was true I needed attention, you who have the ability to give me that attention refuse to give that attention to your own child. What does that say about her or people like that as a mother? It's crazy. It's like, I can give you something and I feel you want it. In my head, I know you want it, but I just refuse to give it to you. Like, get over it, grow up. And not only just with narcissistic parents do you get these things, even with other narcissists that I've met before. Like, for instance, telling somebody I had a food allergy and the person was like, well, I don't believe that. You know, I don't think that there is any evidence for that. Well, really, it is an actual allergy. There's tons of evidence about this. And people, because of the things they do to the food, more and more people get this. It's a gluten allergy. So telling me, no, that you know, that's not accurate. You know, I just don't buy into that. And it's like, how narcissistic do you have to be to tell somebody else? If I'm telling you I have symptoms because of this, you're going to tell me I don't feel what I feel, I don't have any symptoms, and that you know better than me, and basically it's all in my head. This is like what my mother used to tell me. And so when that person said that to me, I was like, I know what I'm dealing with here. So yeah, let me know what you think again in the comments. Again, go ahead and like and go ahead and subscribe. I'm almost done. Not just yet. Just hold on tight. Thank you. So a way you can combat this gaslighting or this crazy making behavior, how they just try to totally control your reality is to write things down that's happened. If they've done something to you, write it down. If you know you have trouble believing yourself and you tend to believe them over yourself, write it down so you remember. Also, have a trusted friend that you can talk to, and your friend can remind you, this is what happened. You're right. They did this to you before. This is not you, sweetheart. You're on point. And I say that because I used to have this friend. And I was telling her about my mom talking about this big bump she got on her head, talking about how she needed to get MRIs and all this stuff, and she needed money for this surgery for her head and all this thing. My friend was like, how many times your mother gonna cry wolf? I said, what do you mean? She said, remember long time ago she was talking about she needed money for that, and then she still never did anything about it. She like, every time you turn around, you telling me that your mama need money for that thing on her head. I mean, how long is this gonna go on? She didn't even know about my mom. She just pointed it out. She was like, I think something wrong with your mom. I think she's trying to use y'all for money. And I thought about it after a while, and everything my mother has done, and I was like, oh my God, this person realized it. And I ain't even tell her how crazy my mama was. But that's the thing, it's helpful to let other people know, so that way if you doubt yourself, you got somebody else to help you and like, remember, this is a pattern, this is not new, come on. Another thing you can do is learning to trust yourself, because when other people have always have you to doubt yourself, sometimes you can begin not to trust your own self. But just remembering that if you feel it, something's true there. Or if you think it, something's true there. And I know that is hard to do, but it takes time that you begin to not always look to other people to make decisions for you. It's like if someone's asking you what restaurant you want to go to, learn to not just say, I don't care, whatever you want to do. Learn to have an opinion. Why? Because that gives you confidence to learn to trust yourself. So if someone asks you to pick a movie, pick it. Even if you got to take 10 minutes to think of it, pick it, because this will help you to trust your reality and keep you grounded within yourself, knowing that you are capable to make decisions and that nothing is wrong with you and that you are okay and that God created you exactly how he wanted you to be created. You know, so just trust in your learning to trust in yourself, believing that if you don't want to be friends with someone, you think someone is misusing you, there is a reason that you feel this way. And you have to learn, and it takes time to stop minimizing yourself, saying, oh, well, you know, maybe I'm feeling wrong about this. Oh, maybe I'm thinking wrong. No, learning that you, for a reason, have been triggered because something has happened to you. Even if it's your gut instincts telling you that something is wrong, it is. And you know, and learning to sit with being uncomfortable with that feeling. Oh, did I make the right decision? I just don't know. Why are you like that? Because someone has made you doubt yourself. But learning to say it is okay. What's the worst that can happen? Even if I did make the wrong decision, is the world going to blow up? Am I unable to fix this problem? What's the worst that can happen? Even if you did make the wrong decision, what do you have to apologize? You can do that. That's not going to kill you. Or do you have to go back and redo something? You can do that. That's not going to kill you. But learning to be comfortable with yourself, because the more you continue not to trust yourself, you open yourself up for other narcissists and other type of abusers who are willing and waiting to control your life and tell you what to think, what to eat, how to do it, how to feel. So let me know what you think and subscribe. Thank you. Bye-bye.